Hello everyone, I'm Yosuke from Rakuten. Rakuten is e-commerce and internet service company based in Tokyo, Japan. I have been in charge of research and development for a cloud storage, LeoFS, since its inception in 2010. LeoFS is unstructured object storage system and highly available, distributed, and eventually consistent storage system. As you may know, LeoFS is open source software. We are published as LeoFS as open source software on GitHub from July of 2012. There is no magic black boxes. That means you are able to easily try to use LeoFS. There is five topics I'd like to cover today. First, I will introduce overview of LeoFS. Then, I will introduce brief benchmark report for LeoFS version 1.0.2. Then, I'd like to share multi-data center replication, which is one of powerful new features. Then, Rakuten software engineer Hiroki Matsue, he will mention LeoFS administer at Rakuten. Finally, I'd like to introduce future plan of LeoFS, LeoFS support, and more. Let's move my presentation. First topic is overview. I think if you look at the big idea at LeoFS, what we are really focused on is three things: high availability, high scalability, and high cost performance ratio. Because unstructured data has been exponentially increasing in our company and services day by day, so we needed to build and develop LeoFS with all of them. Next is LeoFS overview. We really succeeded in designing and implementing LeoFS as simple as possible. As you can see on this slide, LeoFS consists of three core components: gateway, storage, and manager. The role of each component is clearly defined. And also, what I carefully designed LeoFS is three things. First one is to keep high availability. Second one is to keep high performance. It is regardless of huge amount of data and kind of data. Third one is to realize easy administration. Actually, we already provide GUI console, which name is Leo Center. LeoFS Gateway is one of LeoFS components. Gateway consists of first HTTP server, Cavoy, the API handler for REST and S3 API, and object cache mechanism for memory and disk cache. Gateway already provides S3 API, S3 handler, so you are able to easily access LeoFS with S3 clients, such as Dragon Disk, S3 command, and program language clients, Erlang, Python, Java, and so on. Next is about message flow. A client requests an object or a bucket of operation to Gateway. Then, Gateway requests the operation to storage. Gateway retrieves destination storage node from the routing table, which is called the ring. It is generated and distributed at LeoFS manager. It is based on consistent hashing. Finally, storage accepts a request from Gateway. And Gateway already includes built-in support for object cache mechanism. in order to realize keep high performance and reduce network traffic between gateway and storage. Next topic is storage, which is one of the LeoFS components. I'd like to share write and read operation. When executing write or read operation, storage retrieves the destination nodes from the link, similarly to gateway. In case of write operation, storage accepts a request from gateway. Then storage automatically replicates an object into the storage cluster. Finally, storage checks whether the stored object satisfies the consistency level or not. On the other hand, read operation. Storage accepts a request from gateway. Then storage retrieves an object from storage cluster. Finally, storage checks whether retrieved object has inconsistency into the replicated nodes. So inconsistency object will be fixed eventually. In summary, an object keeps consistency with all of them, automatic replication and automatic recover functions. Storage consists of object storage and metadata storage. Also includes replicator and recoverer for eventual consistency. Metadata storage manages and stores attributes and object. On the other hand, object storage manages and stores metadata and raw object, which are merged as a needle into its original data format. I'd like to share LeoFS data structure. An object is managed with metadata storage and object storage. A metadata consists of file name as file name and offset and file size and so on. On the other hand, needle. Needle consists of metadata, body, and footer. There is a reason why needle is this format. Storage is able to recover metadata from this needle. Also, object container consists of plural needles. There are benefits from this format. It is robust and high performance because effect of local file system, it is just little, but also it is necessary for garbage collection. In order to remove unnecessary object from object container, actually we provide the compaction command on manager console. So also, LeoFS already supported to handle a large size object. There are two benefits from this function. First, one is to equalize disk usage in every storage node. Second is to realize high I/O efficiency and high availability. In case of write operation, gateway accepts a large size object from a client. Then, gateway divides a large size object to plural chunk object. Then, gateway requests chunked object to storage cluster. Every chunked object is replicated in storage cluster. On the other hand, read operation. Gateway accepts a large size object from a client. Then, gateway retrieves a metadata and object from the storage cluster. Then, gateway recognizes the number of object, also gateway retrieves chunked object in order of chunked object number from the storage cluster. Next component is manager, which is one of LeoFS components. LeoFS manager always monitors link and node status. So in order to keep running the system with node status monitor and keep consistency with the distributed link. And also, LeoFS has operation commands, storage cluster, storage and gateway commands, and also S3 API related commands, and so on. So I'm going to demonstrate LeoFS how it operates with LeoFS commands. First, I'm going to start LeoFS manager master slave. Then I'm going to start storage nodes. One nodes, two, so you are checked current status. So I started three storage nodes, storage 0, 2, storage 2, and start LeoFS gateway. Okay. I'm going to check status. Launch LeoFS storage cluster. Using command is start. As a result, three storage nodes is launched. Again, check status. All nodes is launched. So I'm going to input a data to storage cluster. First, I'm execute sorry. I type missed. Yes, I'm created a bucket into the storage cluster and check current bucket list. So LeoFS has one bucket, which name is photo. Then I'm going to input several files using S3 command. So now I'm input a lot of files into the storage cluster. So then I'm going to change bucket access control. Photo bucket is able to read only using update ACL, 05236 is access key, and public read is changed packet ACL. So you are able to access Erlang logo from the browser. This request reached LeoFS system. So I demonstrate LeoFS briefly. So sorry. The detail, we have already published the detail on our website and GitHub. So next topic is brief benchmark report. We took LeoFS benchmark with two cases last week. I recognize LeoFS performance at bottleneck, those benchmarks. First one is LeoFS kept in stable performance, so the benchmark. Second is bottleneck is disk I/O. Third one is the cache mechanism contributed to reduce network traffic between gateway and storage. First case is group of value ranges. And number of storage nodes is 5, number of gateway nodes is 1, and number of managed nodes is 2. Read and write operation ratio is 9 to 1. Difference of second case is just only a read and write operation, which is 8 to 2. Server spec is like this. CPU, Xeon processor, memory 96 GB, disk I used HDD, and server in storage nodes I used 2 TB disk, and network card is 10 GB Ethernet card. This slide is environment. Network is 10 Gbps, OS is CentOS, and so on. LeoFS version is 1.0.2, and also system concierge level, number of replica is 3, successful write is 2, number of successful read is 1. Group value size, group of value size is 4 groups. From 1 KB to 1.5 MB. We use the virtual bench with the benchmark. Actually, we implement virtual bench driver for LeoFS, which is published on GitHub. In this case, operation per second, about 1,500 operation per second. And also, mean latency of both put and get is about 15 milliseconds. It is good result for us. And in case of this benchmark, LeoFS performance reached 6.5 Gbps into the 10 Gbps network. And gateway spends the processing of the network traffic, which is 16% of overall read. That means gateway cache mechanism contribute to keep high performance and reduce network traffic. This slide is first case is memory and CPU usage. Top of slide is top of its memory usage. Gateway is using as memory cache, and also storage is using the page cache. CPU load average for 5 minutes is less 1.0. On the other hand, this slide is second case. Its only difference with first case is read-write operation ratio, which is 8:2. In this case, operation per second is about 1,000, and mean latency of both put and get is around 17 and 19 milliseconds. From this slide, compare first case with second case. This slide is comparison network traffic between first case and second case. As a result, second case was 0.7 gigapps lower than first case. And also, this slide is comparison disk utilization between first case and second case. As a result, second case was 1.8 times higher than first case. And this slide comparison CPU load for five minutes. As a result, second case was 1.6 times higher than first case. Also, in second case, both disk utilization and CPU load were higher than first case. So I want to say LeoFS bottleneck is disk I/O. In conclusion, LeoFS kept in a stable performance through the benchmark. Bottleneck is disk I/O. The cache mechanism contributed to reduce network traffic between gateway and storage. So I'm going to introduce managed data center replication as one of new features. We provide this function with LeoFS 1.0. As I mentioned, from above, unstructured data has been exponentially increasing in our company. So we needed to realize high scalable and high available storage system with easy operation through this function. What we are carefully designing this function is that we did not implement it with no single point failure and no performance degradation. We designed this function as simple as possible. There are two important features. First one is the operation to build clusters. Second is we adopt asynchronous data replication, storage, stacks, and compressed object before transferring them to remote clusters. Third one is to automatically recover inconsistency object between local and remote clusters. I'm going to introduce how the merge data center replication operates between clusters. First, about preparation of the merge data center replication. First one is to execute the join command on the manager console. In order to communicate local cluster with remote clusters, then every manager starts the monitor remote link and system configuration at every manager. It is necessary to keep to communicate with remote clusters. Next is about stacking object. First, storage prior to replicate an object in the local clusters. Then, an object stacked into an object transfers container in order to realize asynchronous object transfer. The default object container size is 32 megabytes. So you can able to easily change this configuration. When the container capacity is full, Storage sends stacked object to remote cluster. Also, one, sorry, next is transpiling stacked object. We adapt the asynchronous data replication as a way of replication between clusters. A stacked object is compressed with LZ4 in order to reduce network traffic as much as possible. A remote cluster node automatically replicates the data into the own cluster. Next is about investing stored object. First, the node of the local cluster retrieves metadata of the stored object. Then, compare them between cluster in order to fix inconsistency object eventually. The inconsistency objects are stacked into the object transfer container again. As I mentioned this function, you are able to easily build a multi-cluster environment from this function. So next topic, Rakuten software engineer Hiroki Matsue, he will introduce LeoFS administration at Rakuten.
Okay, thank you. Hello, I'm Hiroki. So I will talk about the LeoFS administration at Rakuten. So in Rakuten, we are using LeoFS for many services. For example, storage platform, file sharing services, and portal site or photo storage or background storage of OpenStack. And today, I will talk about the storage platform and the file sharing services. First, storage platform. So in Rakuten, we have many types of services like e-commerce or photo sharing or portal site or bookmarking or blog site. And we have many types of services. And to support these kind of services, we have many platforms like PaaS. It's like similar to Heroku and IaaS and such. Platform and storage platform. At storage platform, we are using LeoFS. And to use LeoFS, we consider these kind of 4 points. Finally, LeoFS reduced costs over 70% compared with enterprise storage system. And as Yosuke mentioned about it, so LeoFS achieved high reliability. Over 2 years, LeoFS had been worked at Rakuten without any service downtime. And we do not need special servers for the LeoFS, so it's easy to scale and it's easy to prepare new servers. And also, LeoFS support S3 API, and we can use many types of clients. And this is a usage ratio in the storage platform. Now, we prepared 600 terabyte disks for the platform, and now we're already using 450 terabytes, and the number of files is 600 million, and the daily growth is 100 gigabytes per day, and daily requests is 30 million to the platform. and it's still growing now. And this is a system overview of the platform. We are using 4 gateway servers and 40 storage node and 2 managers. And total disk space is, I said 600 terabyte, and number of files is 600 million. And daily access is 400 megabps average, and it will increase more in future. And to keep the status of LeoFS be healthy, we are using Ganglia and Nagios for the monitoring. Ganglia is collecting server status like CPU usage or memory status, and it makes graphs for the user with GUI. And Nagios checking server status, it's the port is working or the server is not down or not. So, and if the server will down or storage will down, Nagios will send mail to the administrator. Not only CPU or memory status, Ganglia and Nagios checking LeoFS status. LeoFS provides SNMP protocol to check status, internal status of LeoFS. So we also checking these kind of values. So we aim to cover all over services in Rakuten with multi data center replication feature of LeoFS. So if we could release this feature, the latency will reduce dramatically, and the reliability will increase more. Second is file sharing service. We are using on cloud for the GUI file sharing application. On cloud is open source, provide open source web application which implemented by PHP, and it's similar to Dropbox. We are using it in internal file sharing. So why we are using on cloud and this kind of file sharing? Our employees increasing dramatically now, and we want to share confidential files smoothly, and we want to share large files like videos. So we are we providing file sharing service internally. For that, we are using LeoFS and on cloud. For example, we are using we are holding group-wide meeting every week, and we want to share knowledge or information directly with vision or movies and sounds. And but it's very large file, and we want to archive all videos. Then we are using this service. So mainly we are sharing documents like PDF or PowerPoints or keynotes or something, and videos with this service for group companies. And now 20 companies are recorded in the DB, and over 10 countries group companies connect to the service. And over 4,000 users and 10,000 teams are recorded on the DB now. And this is the overview of the file sharing service. We are install on cloud to the web servers. The number is around 5 now. And we are to avoid single point of failure over the system. We make redundancy for each component. We have 2 LDAP servers and 2 MariaDB servers, and we are using Roma. Roma is also open source distributed KVS, which implemented by Rakuten. If you have interest in it, please search it later. And we also aim to cover all employees, group company with this system, and with LeoFS and on cloud. And through the cloud storage, we want to empowering the service and the users with LeoFS. Thank you for listening. This is a use case in Rakuten. And I pass the mic again to Yosuke.
So last topic is future plans of LeoFS. We are planning to implement powerful features with LeoFS 1.2. We are aiming to centralize huge amount of data, various kind of data and structure in LeoFS. So from last month, we have been tackling to implement this feature. Because we thought we need to support both S3 REST API for online transaction and NFS for backend services in order to realize data hub which is needed to at our company and services. Also, we are planning to provide Leo Insight at LeoFS QoS system. QoS means quality of services. And Leo Center version 1.0 adds LeoFS Web GUI console, actually, which is already released. And also, I consider a better platform can be LeoFS integrated with OpenStack. But it is the planning phase. After we release LeoFS version 1.1, we will start to implement this feature. My presentation is the end. If you're interested in LeoFS, please contact me as. Do you have any questions?
Hi, yeah. Well, first of all, thank you for sharing this interesting work that you've been doing, working on.
Oh, thank you.
But I've seen that you say that in the future you may want to integrate LeoFS into OpenStack.
Exactly.
Do you have some numbers comparing how LeoFS performs compared to React, CS, yes. Cloud Storage, or OpenStack Swift?
Yes.
Or actually, maybe it has some features that the other two doesn't have, or something like that. Why shall I use LeoFS rather than the other two?
Yes, actually, we benchmarked and survey other DFS such as Swift, React CS, Gluster, and so on. But we did not publish benchmark report. It is very sensitive report. So actually, we benchmarked them in our company. So we publish a report internal in-house, but does not publish.
Are you planning to
community,
make it public?
Community and so on.
Are you planning to release this survey or this benchmark to the public so that we can know whether?
Oh, yes, sure.
You will make it public then, or eventually, or?
Yes, so I'll considering that. So later, we discuss publish benchmark report for you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Otherwise, I have one myself.
Yeah.
It's clearly a quite big system you have in Rakuten, and LeoFS is playing a major role. Has anybody outside Rakuten started using LeoFS?
We used LeoFS from 2011. So first LeoFS version is photo storage. So from 2012, I implemented to cloud storage for cloud storage. Name is changed from ARIA to LeoFS. So now Hiroki mentioned. LeoFS has to spread LeoFS in our company and services. So next year, we will use LeoFS about 80%.
Okay, so that's fine. But how about other companies than Rakuten? Have other people started using LeoFS since it's open source?
Yes, actually, his project is used.
So at least one. Okay, that's good. Any other questions? Yes, we have one there. You go.
So is there any documentation somewhere on how you handle failures or detect problems in LeoFS or other than the source code?
Sorry, I did not catch you.
Is there any documentation on how failures are handled in LeoFS other than the source code, or is there a kind of full documentation or blog or something like this?
You are asking about how to handle errors or how to handle the system errors. You are asking about? LeoFS provides how to manage errors in LeoFS. Of course, it's provided by the original site. And if you have, and also we are providing a FAQ page, and you will be find some knowledge how to handle failures. Yeah, and of course, if you have any other issues or questions, you can put the questions to GitHub issues or other communities. And also, we continue to release our knowledge to outside.
Any further questions? Going once, twice. Okay, sold, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Please remember to vote.